guys, it's Sam, and this is my spoiler-free review of The Sky is Everywhere by Jandy Nelson. The Sky is Everywhere is about our main character, Lenny, and she has recently lost her sister to a tragic death. You find that at the very beginning, that she recently lost her sister like 2 months ago or less, and she's still kind of reeling from it. She's going through a grieving process, and it's basically following her in the months after that happens and how she deals with it, how she deals with her family relationships and her friends and boys and the whole thing. So I've never read anything by Jandy Nelson, and I am not a big contemporary reader, although it's slowly kind of changing because I am finding some favorite authors in the contemporary genre. But I went into this not really expecting much. I've heard a lot of really good things about Jandy Nelson and that she rips your heart in two, but I was just like, I'm not a really big contemporary person. I probably won't like it that much, whatever, whatever. I was wrong. So let me talk about the characters the most, because the characters are what really drive the story, and the characters are so well done in this book that I was completely blown away. So first we have Lenny. There is a lot of things about Lenny that I do not understand personally because I've never experienced that. I've never experienced a death of a family member that's very close to me. I don't have any siblings, so the sister bond I didn't really understand, you know, from like a first person experience kind of thing, but I could kind of get in her head and I kind of understood where she was coming from. She makes a lot of decisions that you're just like, what are you doing? But the grieving process is really interesting, and how humans grieve and how different all of us grieve. And I thought that was explored really well in here between Lenny and all of her family members. Lenny also lives with her grandma and her uncle, and her mom is absent and we don't know who her father is. So watching them and their experiences of grief too are really interesting because all the characters in here are so different. And the family is a very eclectic family, and you really got a sense of that. I could really picture all of the members of the family and how they operate. They're very kind of eclectic, not hippie-ish, but borderline. Like, a lot of the things that they do are very, like, eclectic is the only word for it. I don't want to spoil anything about them, but they're a very interesting family, and you really just grow to love them. You don't get to see a ton of all of the characters, obviously, because it is Lenny's story, but the little glimpses you do get of the family members, you really have a sense of them and who they are and what they believe in, their personalities, everything, and it is so wonderful. Also, you have one of Lenny's good friends. She is in there. It's not like the strongest friendship, obviously, because you have Lenny really dealing with the loss of her sister, who was her closest relationship, and so she really does push most people away. So you don't see a ton of the friend, but the friendship in there was really good and was really realistic. Again, like I said, how she pushes her away, you don't really get to see a ton of her, and I really enjoyed all of that. I really enjoyed the glimpses we kind of did get of the sister. We have these kind of like flashback moments. Lenny writes kind of like journal entries to her sister where she's kind of going through her grieving process, kind of like letters to her sister or like snippets of things that they did or said or whatever. It's across the board. And that is kind of woven into here, which I really, really enjoyed. It really gave like a sense of kind of you're going through the grieving process with Lenny, and I really loved it. So you really do get a sense of her sister and their relationship and everything, and then we have the love interests. Before you go running, and I always say this when I talk about love triangles, there's technically a love triangle in this. The synopsis even talks about there being a love triangle, but I would not necessarily call it a love triangle at all. It's not. It is a situation where there are technically two romantic love interests, sort of, but not really. And I don't want to say anything else about it because I don't want to spoil it or anything, but there are two guys in the picture, and they do have to do with Lenny's grieving process and what's going on, and the whole situation is very interesting. Again, I don't want to say anything and spoil it, but there's a lot going on there, and the way that that's done makes it so the love triangle isn't bad, and like I said, isn't really even a love triangle, and you understand why there's a love triangle in here. And it's so interesting to watch, and there was just so many things that happened in this book where I was like, oh, like, it just really tears your heart out and stomps on it and then puts it back. Something like nice will happen, and there'll be like a cute interaction between like a family member or a friend or her love interest or whatever. And it was just nice. It was a nice balance of the feels and the cute. You know, like, you need a mix of both. Like, I can't read a whole book that's just all feels and you're just ripping my heart out. That's stressful, that's hard, and I don't like that a lot. But the nice mix that we had of both was really nice. I could not put this book down. I was completely addicted to it once I got like 30 pages into it. The plot moves along at a fairly quick pace, and you do kind of see that like it's building up to something, and you're not really sure what it is, and that kind of keeps you reading because you know kind of at one point that things are going to kind of hit the fan at one point, and that is really interesting, and you just kind of are like waiting for that to happen. You're moving with her through her grieving process and through her relationships, and it's all really interesting and fascinating. I read this the beginning of the month during Readorama, and I'm still kind of like, I don't really know how to fully process my emotions. I just know that I loved it so, so much. This book gets a ton of hype, but it's really worth all that hype, and it's really interesting if you like those more like intense reads as far as like dealing with really big issues, you know, like grief and loss and stuff like that, then I think you'd really enjoy this. But if you don't like those kinds of reads, I still think you could enjoy this because, like I said, it's balanced with like nice, funny things that happen too. So I thought this book was beautifully put together, and I plan on reading more of Janie Nelson's works because I just really loved her writing and the way everything was put together and everything. So it will come as no surprise, this was a 5 out of 5 stars for me. I absolutely adored it, and it really got me wanting to read more contemporary. And now I kind of know what kind of contemporary I like. This kind of mix of like dark with light themes. I really enjoy that, so I'll be reading more of it. I really recommend this to basically everybody. I think a lot of people could really like it. It could appeal to so many people, so really, really loved it. Alright guys, that is it for my spoiler-free review. Comment down below, let me know if you've read this story and what you thought of it. If you've read other books by Janie Nelson, I do have I'll Give You the Sun on my shelf that I plan on reading at some point. I'm kind of putting it off though because I really enjoyed The Sky is Everywhere and I want to kind of give myself a little break and then read that when I feel like I really need it and that I really want to read like a 5-star book. So hopefully I'm not hyping it in my head too much, but I really, really enjoyed her writing. So if you have different other contemporary reads that are that nice mix of like funny and sad, heavier kind of plots, definitely leave it in the comments down below because I want to read more like that. I think I really enjoy that kind of contemporary. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see all of you guys soon. Bye!